వందే శంభుం మాపతిం సురగురుం వందే జగత్కారణం వందే పన్నగభూషణం శశిధరం వందే పశూనాం పతిం వందే సూర్యశశాంకవల్లినయనం వందే ముకుంద ప్రియం వందే భక్తజన ఆశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే భక్తజన ఆశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే శివం శంకరం. ఫ్రెండ్స్, గోల్డ్ ఈజ్ అవైలబుల్ ఇన్ ది బబుల్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎర్త్. పెట్రోల్ ఈజ్ అవైలబుల్ ఇన్ ది ఎర్త్, సో ఆల్సో డీజిల్. Diamonds too are available, but the available diamond is not polished, is not bright, is not fit enough to be ornamental immediately. The diamond is mixed with mud, it is mixed with stones, it is mixed with impurities. Similarly, whether it is kerosene or petrol or diesel, the available oil cannot be used immediately in any vehicle. It is crude oil. It has to be purified. It has to be processed. And then only it is fit to be used as fuel in the vehicles. Gold too is mixed with mud, it is mixed with sand and impurities. What is the first requirement? All the impurities from the gold must be removed, all the dross is to be removed, whatever is unnecessary, it is to be removed, and then it is to be processed, modified, regulated, polished. Then it becomes ornamental, usable, consumable. Gold, petrol, diesel, kerosene, diamond, etc., etc., they are in the crude form, unusable form, dirt. Similarly, man or woman is immediately not refined. He is a crude animal, rude animal, uncivilized animal, uncultured brute. Though diamond is like that in dirt, gold is like that in dust, oil is like that in unnecessary material. As the oil is crude, man is rude. As the oil cannot be used, man too cannot be immediately put to use. So the unusable product, the crude product, has to undergo three stages. First stage, removal of the unnecessary things. Then the existing things are to be regulated, modified. Finally, it is the finished product. The lowest stage is tamas. When a person is sleeping, he is useless. When a person is lethargic, useless. But in that lethargic person, in that tamasic person, in that rude person, in that uncivilized, uncultured person, there is the bright man, usable man. So what is it that is to be removed first? Tamas. What is that tamas in the ordinary sense? Laziness. It is laziness that does not allow us to come to my trivialam. The first requirement is remove tamas, remove the mud, remove the dirt, remove the dust from the gold. If you want that gold, these are all to be removed. The crude oil should become refined oil. The gold mixed with all unnecessary things must become the bright gold. So also diamond, so also anything. Each soul is potentially divine. Each person is talented. Every human being is gifted. There is the talent. But that talent is hidden in tamas. That talent is hidden in touch. So, in Karma Yoga, the first requirement is remove that tamas. In Sanskrit, we have three words. Prakriti. Prakriti is nature. In nature, all the three gunas are available. There is tamas, there is rajas, and there is sattva. Every day and night, we find all the three gunas. In every mind, you find all the three gunas. In every body, you find all the three gunas. And which is the hindrance, which is the obstacle, which is the impediment, which is the nuisance, which prevents the progress, which prevents the promotion, onward march, laziness. In the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna wanted to go away. I don't want to fight. Nakanche vijayam Krishna, nacharajyam sukhanicha. I don't want. I would like to sit under the greenwood tree's shade, close my nostrils, and sit idle, tamas. And what is Krishna's reaction? Kutasva kashmalavidam vishame samupasthitam anarya justam asvargyam akirtikaram arjuna kshudram hrayadaurbalyam. You fool, this is psychic weakness. You would like to remain idle, dull, without activity, come on, stand up. Now the present state of affairs, we don't want to work. We don't want to study. We don't want to do anything. Laziness. The entire Bhagavad Gita first starts with the kajals of Sri Krishna. Kajal means whipping. Get up, man. Stand up, man. What is it that prevents our progress? What is it that prevents the diamond from shining? Mud. What is it that prevents the petrol from being used? Crude nature. What is it that prevents the gold from being bright? Again, dirt. What is it that prevents the student from shining? Laziness. Anybody to that matter. If you want prakriti, first thing is you have to remove the tamasika prakriti in it. If you don't remove that, what will happen? It will be vikruti. Horrible. You go see a person, as soon as he wakes up, saliva will be coming, eyes will be dirty, hair will be clumsy, vikrutakaram sopadaka, dirtiest appearance. So what is it that is being removed from the person? The dirt. Clean it, clean the body, purify the mind. Remove the dirt from gold, from yourself, from mind, from body, from institution. Remove mercilessly. Sri Krishna wanted Arjuna to be rid of laziness first. Be not idle. And if you don't prevent it, you become Vikrutakara, Kumbhakarna. When Kumbhakarna was asleep, Valmiki beautifully described the stature of Kumbhakarna, how dirty, how ugly, how repulsive it is. And that tamas is to be removed. Sita, the person, is caught in three gunas. One is tamasika prakriti Kumbhakarna. Second is the rajasika prakriti Ravana. The third is sattvika prakriti Vibhishana. What did Rama do first? Remove Kumbhakarna. The three brothers are the custodians of Lanka, custodians of this body, custodians of this mind, in which is Jiva kept, in which the person is kept, and that is Sita Devi. The first instruction of Krishna is Arjuna should be free from idleness. The first instruction of Rama is remove that tamasika prakriti kumbhakarna. In Sri Rama Ravana Sangrama, the first removal was Kumbhakarna's death. And then Ravana dynamic activity, too much of activity, and that is 10 heads, 20 hands. He regulated it. He channelized it. One after the other, all the arms are cut, all the heads are cut and finally removed. And what is it that remained? Calmness, tranquility, serenity, sattvic prakriti. What does it do? It is Vibhishana who takes Sita to Rama. It is sattvic prakriti that takes man to a higher level. Samskriti is the highest. The person of Samskriti is Vibhishan. The person of Prakriti, natural feelings, kama, krodha, lobha, all things in Ravan. And the third one, Vikrutakara, Tamasika Prakriti, laziness, and that is Kumbhakarna. One after the other he removed, and Sita was able to get the Sakshatkar of Sri Ramachandra Prabhu. They were united. Jiva goes to that Shiva. This is the order, and Sri Krishna similarly follows. He tells Arjuna, if you take Bhagavad Gita, before the commencement of war, Arjuna's thinking was Tamasika Prakriti. During the war, regulated activity. After the war, again he has to be brought to the sattvic prakriti. But unfortunately, some people stick to that activity. And Krishna wants that sattvic nature to come to the surface. Karmanaha, akarmana, vikarma. There are three things. Action, unlawful action, and then your spectator activity. You will be in a position to enjoy that sattvic nature of calmness when you become a spectator. That Arjuna was unable to develop while doing the activity completely, after completion of the activity completely. That is beautifully presented by Vyasa Maharshi in his excellent illustration. Three stages, Vikruti, Prakruti, highest is Samskruti. Crude oil should become the refined oil. Impure diamond should become the bright diamond. The impure gold should become the bright gold. This process of going up to the highest is Yoga Pyasa. And one after the other you remove and you rise to the top, as is shown by Valmiki in the Ramayana. Even in our day-to-day life, first we clean the room. Tamasika Prakriti, the dirt is to be removed. Arrange the room, activity, and then enjoy the calm beauty of the room. Remove the impure ideas, purify the ideas, settle the ideas, and be absorbed in the calm state. How about our body? First clean the body, beautify the body in an orderly fashion, and then look at your face in the mirror and enjoy the beauty of the face. First you don't do it, and looking at your own face is Atma Sakshatkar, looking at the self. When we reach the highest, Samskriti, the whole process is called Samskara. India is great on account of its steps for the highest state. Karma Yoga is not meant for Arjuna in the Mahabharata. It is meant for everybody in the street, everybody in the country, everybody in the college. What is not necessary to be read? What is to be read is to be regulated. After reading, you just retain it and absorb in it. Whether it is study, or activity, everywhere these three stages, and then be in a position to see action in inaction, inaction in action. And that is the highest state. Now Krishna has to teach Arjuna that. Beautifully Vyasa Mahabharata describes. Mahabharata war has come to a close on the 18th day. We are all aware of it. Duryodhana and his brothers have been killed. Arjuna is now very, very happy that he became Vijaya. He looked at Krishna. Hey, Mr. Krishna, yes, I would like to see how many people have been killed by me. Take me round the entire Kurukshetra field. I would like to see. Now, old man is coming, that dynamism is coming up. Instead of reaching a state of spectatorship, he has been a victim of ahankara. Krishna looked at him. Yes, sir. Chariot was taken round the entire Kurukshetra field. He saw hundreds of people without head, without hands, without legs. And Arjuna was very, very happy that he had been the killer of many, many people. At the end of the Kurukshetra field, on a tall tree, Arjuna found a man seated. When so many people are dead, who is this person? He called him down. The person came down. What's your name? Arjuna asked. My name is Barbarika, sir. What are you doing there? I am recording the entire Mahabharata Yuddha. I see. You have a video camera? Yes, sir. When did you start recording? Right from the first day when you said, I don't want kingdom. From that time till to now, it is recording, sir. Very good. Why are you sitting? Sir, I am blessed with a particular boon. Wherever I fight, the opposite party will win. I don't like Duryodhana. I cannot sit and fight on his behalf. If I fight that side, Pandavas will lose. And I cannot be sitting here. If I sit with you, they will win. Both things I did not like. Therefore, Krishna advised me not to do anything and enjoy the activity everywhere. Akarmanaha karmanaha. Pasye, see, in action, action in inaction, and the cameraman is recording all activities silently. A mind, spectator mind, observing everything, recording everything, silently enjoying action. Then Arjuna had a desire. Mr. Barbarika, you are recording? Yes, sir. The whole film is ready? Yes, sir. See, while defeating Bhishma over my eyes, I want to see. While killing Drona, how bold I looked, how lion-like I was, I want to see. While killing that Karna, how did I look like? Come on, replay it, show it on the screen. Then that gentleman said, sir, it is true I recorded entire Mahabharata Yuddha 18 days. But sir, I never saw you there anywhere. What nonsense you speak? I have killed Karna. I was responsible for the fall of Bhishma. It was I who did away with Drona. And you say you have never seen me. Whom did you see? Only that gentleman said, Krishna, sir. But Krishna was not doing anything on the battlefield. He was sitting idle. He was only driving the chariot. I was the real fighter. I was the dynamic person. How is it you are able to see only Krishna, not myself? Who is the real doer? Karma, akarma, vikarma. You must be in a position to be balanced while being a performer of the activity. You must be so quiet, so wonderful. You could be a yogi without doing. You could be a yogi while doing. And who is a yogi? A person of calmness, spectatorship. Parvati Devi once had a doubt. Sri Rama mantra was being recited by Lord Shiva. He was reciting Ram, 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 Ram. Why do you recite Rama's name? Parvati asked. Because he's a great yogi, Parmeshwara said. But I don't consider him to be a yogi. See, in the cave, his wife is stolen by Ravana and he is weeping, 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 weeping. Does a yogi weep? You do not know. Natana Sutradhari, Maya Manusha Vigraha, Nara Avatara. He has to act like that, therefore. No, no, I don't believe. Parvati came all the way from Amarnath to test Ram. She came in the disguise of Sita Devi, and Rama was then weeping for Sita, holding Lakshmana in his hands. The moment Sita Devi entered into the cave, Ma, how is it you have come all the way from Amarnath, leaving Lord Shiva alone in the midst of his sobbings, weepings? He never lost his balance. Is it ever possible? Long ago, I was acting on the stage. I was given the role of Narasimha. I have to drag Hiranyakashipu to my lap, put him on my lap, tear his bubbles, take out his nerves, etc. I was shouting. My eyes were bloody, blood red, blood red. And at the top of my voice, I was shouting, roaring and all that. My wife was standing by the side of the screen. You're useless fellow, don't shout so much. Come, have a cup of coffee, and then you can act. I looked at him, wait, wait, I am done. Amidst Narasimha's activity, I was a calm man. Amidst all our activities, we must be serene. We should not lose our association with the calm self. Karma yoga is removal of the impurities, regulation of the activities, stabilization of the mind. When you are stabilizing, when you are making it tranquil, you become a spectator. Barbarika was a wonderful character in the Mahabharata. He recorded the doer apparently is Arjun, the non-doer apparently is Sri Krishna, but whose activity can be really permanent? It is the person whose mind is tranquil. Having come to Prashanti, let us try to be real karma yogis. First, remove that tamasika prakriti. When you remove the tamasic prakriti, all our day will be long, bright, dynamic and useful. The entire prashanti will look different. The person will look different. The organization will look different. Only one thing is to be removed, Kumbhakarna, lethargy. When that is removed, all the activities can be channelized. They can be regulated. They can be systematized, absolutely no tension, no worry. And at any point of time during the day and time or night, we will be peaceful. Having come to Prashanti, let us not think of only one aspect, getting a certificate. Let us improve our lives. Let us try to become yogis. Serene, calm, tranquil spectators, akarmana, akarmana, vasye. In action, see in action. Action, see it in inaction. And this is from Virkruti or to Samskruti we have to progress. India is a land of Samskruti culture. India is a land of karma yoga. Our ancestors, rishis have done Brahmandamana work, excellent work they have done, and they are always calm and tranquil. By the grace of God Almighty, having come to Prashanti, let us become karma yogis, let us purify ourselves, let us regulate our activities, let us stabilize them, let us systematize them, so that we all remain peacefully useful, usefully peaceful. Let us remain peacefully useful, usefully peaceful, and the great karma yogi is Sri Krishna. Let's meditate on him.